هو الغني الحميد. Verily Allah is al-ghani, the self-sufficient, the rich, al-hamid, the praiseworthy. We read all of these names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But when it comes to reality, we might forget for a while. We might forget that Allah هو الرزاق ذو القوة المتين is the giver of rizq, the sustainer, the provider. That's why we might, some might compromise when it comes to rizq just because they're going to suffer for a while. إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الرَّزَّاقُ. It's Allah who gives rizq. Why would you compromise and go against His will to get some rizq? Whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decides for you, we believe in this. Faith, aqeedah, firm iman and belief and faith in our heart should be like this. وَعْلَمْ أَنَّ مَا أَصَابَكَ لَمْ يَكُنْ لِيُخْطِئَكَ. You have to know firmly in your heart that whatever happens or comes to you is never gonna go away from you. وَمَا أَخْطَأَكَ لَمْ يَكُنْ لِيُصِيبَكَ. And you have to know for sure. These are the words that the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam told to the little boy Abdullah ibn Abbas, his cousin, one day. And you have to know for sure and have faith and firm belief in this, that whatever goes away from you, whatever you miss, there is no way that you can get it. Because it's determined. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala determines everything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala defines and decides everything. Azza wa jalla. So back to the honor and dignity that we have to retain in our nation, in our ummah. Let's read what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, addressing us in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to have this pride and dignity only in the deen, or in His way, in following Him, in being with Him, in being associated with Him alone. قال ومن أحسن قولا ممن دعا إلى الله وعمل صالحا وقال إنني من المسلمين. Who is better than the one who says ممن دعا إلى الله, who invites for the sake of Allah or for the way of Allah, who has better saying than the one who calls for Allah, does good deeds and say I am amongst the Muslims. I am from the Muslims. I belong to Muslims. Who is better than this person? And the answer should be that nobody is better than this. If you feel you are associated with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you should feel that nobody is better than you. Not out of being arrogant or something, but because this is what it is. You are associated to al-Ali al-Muta'ali al-Kabir al-Azim, the most high, the most great subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are his, from Hizbullah. You are from the group of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you feel this, you will feel the highest amount and level of dignity and pride. Brothers, inshallah, if those who are in the back, if they do not have any thing in their back or something, please, Salatul Jum'ah, yani we have a lot of etiquettes, not because I want to make it hard, but because some people in this very time are sleeping while the khutbah is done. They are sleeping. Yani, forgive me, I'm trying my best to put it in the most attractive way, but some people are sleeping while the khutbah is delivered, which is not right. Please move forward, unless you have back pain or something. Move forward and fill the gaps. And the Prophet ﷺ used to say so. And the source of our pride and dignity is to follow Muhammad ﷺ. If you have any gap in front of you, fill it first. Because if everybody would go to the corner to the room, to the walls, it's not right. I'm going to quote a few stories, and I hope time will allow, inshallah ta'ala, a couple of stories that happened to Sahaba and people, human beings like us. Usama ibn Zayd, and all of us know who is Usama ibn Zayd. حب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, وحب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, one of the most beloved people of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. He is the son of Zayd ibn Harisa, the only Sahabi mentioned by name in the Quran, Zayd. Mentioned in Surah Al-Ahzab. Nabi ﷺ used to love his dad too much. And he used to love him after his dad too much. Usama is the one who leads the army. Nabi ﷺ appointed him to lead the army to go and fight against Romans at the very end of his life. And now Nabi ﷺ would die even before this army would march forward. And Sahaba would disagree, should we let this army move forward or just, you know, think this is Usama ibn Zayd. He was very young. When Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam died, he was 16, 17, according to some narrations. But this happened in the time of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, so he was even younger than this, much younger than this. Let's review this story to take the lesson and pride and izzah from this boy, Muslim boy. Hakim ibn Hizam, one of the leaders of Quraysh, you know, of one of the leading people in the of his time, yani during the time when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he did not accept Islam yet, but he used to love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam too much. As all the Quraysh people, they used to love Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and trust him, even though they are fighting against him, they used to love him. They knew he is on the truth. Hakim ibn Hizam was one of these people. He loved Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he was, you know, he disagreed with him. He did not want to follow Islam, but he still respect the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. One day he decided to bring him. He was well-to-do, so he was in the market and he found a very nice dress that is sold in the market, and this was the dress of Malikul Yaman, Saif ibn Dhi Yazan. This was the dress of the king of Yemen, and now it's sold in the market for a very high price. He got it, and he traveled all the way to Medina to just give it as a gift to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Although he was not Muslim, and Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam yani accepted it from him, and it was very, very awesome. Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam put it on and give khutbah, and the Sahabi who narrates the hadith, he said, "I never saw anybody shiny and bright like Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam while he was dressing this very nice clothes and dress." Then Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because he did not want to be to look like different from his companions and so on, this was the only time that he put it on. He would take it off and give it as a gift to Usama ibn Zayd. Usama ibn Zayd, this little boy, because he used to love him too much. Usama ibn Zayd was from very, very poor and humble family. He was not like from big family, or he doesn't have anything other than Islam, other than being Muslim. And Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam would give him this gift. And even before Hakim ibn Hizam leaves to Mecca, when he was walking, he saw Usama ibn Zayd having the gift that he himself had given to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam a while ago. He said, "How you dress this? This is the yani libas al-murug. This is the dress of king. You little boy, you dress this." Listen to what Usama ibn Zayd said. قال أو تلبس أنت حلة ملك اليمن. You dress the clothes of the king of Yemen. قال نعم. He said yes. Why not? أنا خير من ذي يزن. I am better than him. وأمي خير من أمه وأبي خير من أبي. I am better than the king of Yemen. My father is better than his. My mother is better than his. Why? His father, by the way, used to be a very humble, poor slave until Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam would free him. Didn't possess anything in life. But he said, Usama ibn Zayd, I am better than the king of Yemen. That you're talking about. My father is better than his. My mother is better than his mother. It's because of Islam. See how a boy, little boy from the community of Medina, raised by Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, would talk. That's it. He would admire. Hakim ibn Hizam would admire this reply and this response from him, and he would go back. When you go back to Mecca, he would, you know, mention it as something amazing, how a little boy like this would talk with this pride. Brothers and sisters, we should feel that we are better than others. Not because we feel it like this, but because Allah said, كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ. You are the best nation set out for people. Didn't he say that in the Quran? He said it in Surah Al-Imran. كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ. You, Muslims, believers, are the best of all nations set out for people. What is the source? What is the reason? What is the source of this superiority over people? He said in the other ayah, وَأَنْتُمُ الْأَعْلَوُونَ. You are the superior. إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. If you are true believers. If you are believers. And he said in this very ayah, تَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَتَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرُ. You are the best of all nations to be said to people. تَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ. Because you establish good. You order and enjoin good. وَتَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ. You forbid evil. And this is deen. Deen is to apply